It is a dramatic change being proposed to put more casino cash in Uncle Sam's pockets.
Meaning less money in your pockets. And we know lots of folks from Hawaii love to go to Vegas and gamble. So here's what you need to know. The IRS is thinking about lowering the amount for slot machine winnings that get reported from $1,200 to $600.
And that's for any single jackpot if you're so lucky. The proposal not only popular with casinos, or not popular with casinos or players, but it will cause you to think twice about visiting Hawaii's ninth island, will it? That's the question. Before you decide, hear what our Bridget Namata learned today. She talked to a tax expert and got some answers. Bridget.
Well, if you're a fan of slot machines, this could affect you. I'm told you're supposed to report all winnings, but for anything under $1,200, casinos don't require you to fill out a form and report it to the IRS. So who could this proposal affect the most? I turned to a tax expert to find out. Rowan Matsuura, a certified public accountant, told me it could affect people taking standard deductions, like seniors. If you're already taking standard deductions, you'll have to pay more taxes on the lower winnings.
So does that mean a gambler's winnings mean nothing?
No, the gambler's winnings, you're supposed to pick up all of your income that you win. Gambling, but you're also able to offset it with any gambling losses. So most people will have enough losses to offset their winnings, but the way it is on the tax return, you can't really benefit from those losses unless you're already itemizing your deductions. So that's why seniors already have that standard deduction that the IRS gives them, so they're just going to be paying more taxes in the end, I think.
Masaura says while it's not a popular idea among gamblers, the proposal makes it more consistent with reporting requirements for table games. I called Vacations Hawaii to see what they thought of the proposal. They told me they're still looking into it. The IRS is holding a public hearing in Washington, D.C. on June 17th. We'll let you know what happens. Bridget Namata, KHON2 News.